What is going on, people? Time Passer here. In this video, I'm going to talk about something that is quite common in GTA Online, but is still not known by so many players. So stay tuned for the video if you know exactly how to be AFK in GTA Online without actually getting kicked. So basically, before starting the video, let me tell you that if you stay inactive in GTA Online for more than 15 minutes, then the game will kick you out of the session, and a warning sign like this will appear on your screen. Which makes sense to me, but the thing is, when you're on screen, when you're basically on this screen, you're a bit offline or something, as your businesses aren't gonna grow at all if that's why you are being AFK for. While 15 minutes, on the other hand, on PC is more than enough if you want to, if you want to go to the bathroom or something. But if you want to stay in the same lobby or for longer, then stay tuned for this video. So let's get the video going. So the first thing you have to do is basically go to the pause menu and open up graphics settings. When you go to the graphics settings, you will see an option called pose on basically focus lost, and you have to make sure that you turn this off. And if you turn this off, it's gonna allow you to minimize your game window and still make the game running in the background. In this way, you will be able to do some other stuff on your PC, and on the other hand, your game will keep running in the background. Now the next thing you want to do is basically retire CEO or MC president, so that your businesses don't get raided while you're idle and you have no idea that it's getting raided, and you'll end up losing products instead of gaining it. Now from this point on, you can basically simply go to your apartment, bunker, arcade, nightclub, penthouse, or whatever you have, and watch TV or something, and the game will consider you to be active and you won't be kicked out of the session for being idle. Be sure to do this in a solo session, as I'm going to take much less PC load, and there are some various other reasons as well. But if you try this method, then be ready to pay for so many expenses. Only the bunker itself is going to cost you 9.4k per 48 minutes, which is the 1 day of in-game, which is 1 day of GTA Online. Which in my opinion kills the whole point of being AFK, as you're paying so much money. It's just bunker, and in my opinion total it's going to cost like 40k or something. I hope I'm wrong, but now basically there's a way to avoid some of those daily fees, if not all. Now the first thing you want to do is basically go to your pull menu and start a mission called Blow Up, as this mission is much easier to do. Make sure you don't invite any players to this mission when so basically you have to do this all alone. Now when you load into the mission, you'll be given an objective to destroy some cars. You can either go up and blow them up and then go back to your apartment, or you can directly go to your apartment. Well, you have to make sure that you know the location of your apartment, because the apartment sign that's appearing in the minimap is not going to appear on your minimap this time when you're on a mission. So you have to know the exact location of your apartment. And when you're in an apartment, just sit on a couch and turn on TV. After that, you're basically AFK, and you can go away if you like. If you want to minimize the game, basically, and do some other things, you don't want to go away from PC, then you want to go to the settings and go and switch to windowed mode. And if possible, set your resolution to as low as possible, which will be 800 by 600. So what this will do is it's not going to eat up all of your PC usage, and the good thing is it's not going to take all the space on your background. Basically, they will have a small window and you'll be fine to go. And the good another thing is basically it's gonna put much less load on your PC as well. if that's what you're concerned, like much less fan noises and all that. And from this point on, you're basically good to go, and you will be able to use your PC just as usual, and the game will keep running in the background. Lower the graphic settings too if you basically don't want to put so much load on your PC and you're concerned about fan noises and electricity bills and all that. So you'll be fine to go. And from this point on, browse internet, and if you put the settings to as low as possible, then there are chances, if you've got a good PC, you'll be able to play some other games as well, as it's not gonna put so much load on your disk drive, which is a good thing. Now, that pretty much covers the entire video of this entire topic of this video. And like this video if you liked it, and share it, subscribe to this channel for more gaming videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Till then, peace, bye-bye.